Okay, now I wanted to stay until 9:30 for this talk. Is it okay with everybody if I go until 9:45? Is that okay? All right, if you're not okay with that, then the rest of us will beat you up, so. So, okay. Second ayah. Ar-Rahman, what? Allam al-Qur'an. And I'll first talk to you about the two ayat together. Allam al-Qur'an, khalaq al-insan. So many people here know the surah. Subbihisma rabbika al-a'la alladhi khalaqa fasawwa walladhi qaddara fa hada. Allah says in Surah Al-A'la, he talks about himself, then he says he created. Alladhi khalaqa. He created. And in the next ayah he says walladhi qaddara fa hada. He says he created and then he guided. So what was mentioned first? Creation was mentioned first. Then he talked about guidance. Ibrahim alayhi salam, alladhi khalaqani fahuwa yahdini. Yaqul alladhi khalaqani fahuwa yahdini. Allah is the one who created me and he's the one who guides me. What was mentioned first? Creation, then guidance. Surah Ar-Rahman does not say Ar-Rahman khalaq al-insan 'allama al-Qur'an. No. Ar-Rahman 'allama al-Qur'an khalaq al-insan. This time guidance is mentioned first, creation is mentioned second. It's unusual. It's unusual. Because the order of things is Allah created me first, Allah created you first, and then he guided us. He guided us second, if you look at the order of things. But Allah breaks that order in this surah. I won't answer that question yet. I want to keep that question in your mind. Why is this sequence different? Why is guidance being mentioned before creation in this surah? But I want to talk to you about something else. Please pay attention to this part. One of the most important parts of today's dars. In a classroom, this is not a classroom. This is a lecture. Some of you are on Facebook right now. Some of you are getting the best sleep of your life. Some of you are just looking around, what's going on here? Where am I? That's happening. And some of you are paying attention. Some of you, the eyes stay with me and then they start going up a little. That happens to some of you. Then the best is when some of you are sitting like this, making eye contact with me and going. That means you have no idea what's going on. Right? So this is not a classroom. Because in a classroom, I check everyone. Hey, what did I just say? Hey, you, tell me what I just said. Hey, let's have a test right now. That's what I do in a class. I constantly test. This is a lecture. You could get away with anything. I say, how many kinds of communication are there? One guy in the back goes, 17. But it's okay, he can say that. I won't mind. It's fine. But you know what? When you're in a class, then the teacher's job is to make sure every student understands. Right? But sometimes there are some students, I still remember, I can give you an example. I prepared a lecture about Arabic, one of the lessons of Arabic grammar. I go to my class and I teach the lesson. I say, I spend 2 hours at night. How am I going to teach this lesson? This is going to be such an amazing lesson, they will give me an Academy Award after I finish teaching this lesson. So I teach this lesson, and I am so proud of myself, I start giving myself a pat on the back. That was amazing. Students are happy. One student raises his hand. He goes, after 1 hour, he goes, Ustad? I was like, yeah? I don't understand. What don't you understand? Anything. Okay, you don't understand anything. So let me start over. Let me give you the entire dars again. This time I will only make eye contact with you. Every 2 minutes I say, you okay? Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. You okay? One whole hour goes by. I say, Alhamdulillah. All the other students are like, why are we doing this again? But then this student raises his hand again. Ustaz, I have a question. Yeah, he says, please ask your question. I still don't get it. Now, if you have ever been in a classroom, math class, English class, right? Islamic studies class, and a student does that, after the whole class is done, I don't understand. And he does it a second time. Is the teacher happy or angry? Yeah. We can't do that stuff in America, but I know I'm over here. In Pakistan, in Bangladesh, in India, I don't know if about here. But we give our students a different kind of lesson after that. You know? So, the students, and then I say, you know what? School is over. All the kids are going home. Why don't you stay in the office? I will sit in the office. I will not have lunch today. I will explain it to you again. I sit him down. I explain it to him again. Another way. If the first way didn't work and the second way didn't work, I'll find a third way to explain it to you. I finish explaining and he says, Ustad, I don't know if teaching is the right profession for you because I still, I don't understand. I don't get it. Have you tried taxi driving or anything else? Because clearly teaching isn't the right thing for you. So I say, okay, I'm not giving up on you. Why don't you come to my house for dinner? As we eat dinner, I'll explain it to you again. Same thing after dinner, I say, why don't you move into my house? Does any teacher ever do that? Once a student says, I don't get it, the first time, maybe he's confused. The second time, maybe he's slow. The third time, he's just messing with you. He's just playing with you now. Now, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was the best teacher ever in human history. And not just history, even in the future of humanity, there will never be a better teacher than Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And in education, you need an excellent teacher and you need an excellent curriculum. And there will be never a better curriculum than the Qur'an. So you have the best teacher and you have the best curriculum. And the students were Quraysh. The students were all of Quraysh. And the lessons were easy. The lessons were not calculus. The lessons were not quantum physics. The lessons were simple. If I was talking to 7-year-old children and I was told, summarize the Meccan Quran. Meccan Quran is 2/3 of the Quran. Summarize it to these 7-year-old children in 5 minutes. I say, I don't need 5 minutes, I need 1 minute. Allah is one. Don't be like previous nations who didn't believe in Allah. Believe in his messengers, believe in the akhirah, be a servant and slave to Allah. What else is there? It's done. Everything is covered. That's the entire Madani Meccan Quran. You know, that's the gist of it. The lessons are not hard. But how many years is the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam told to teach the same people, the same Quraysh? How many years he's teaching them? 12 years, over a decade. He's teaching the same people over and over again. And they hear the best lessons ever to be taught. And they listen to it in their custom language. Allah made it for them especially. For that person who's talking to Rasulullah SAW. And ayah came from above to talk to that guy. And he says, I don't get it. Give me something else. I'm not impressed. Give me something else. Does Allah have a right to be angry? Allah has a right to be angry. Any normal teacher will be angry. Now even go a little step further. They don't just say, I don't understand. I told you they become stubborn. And when they become stubborn, they want to make fun of the ayat. And they make fun of the teacher, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. They make fun of him. Does that make Allah angry? Yeah, it makes Allah very angry. And when Allah gets angry, what does he have the power to do? Subhanallah. Has he done it with previous nations before? He's done it. But I want to tell you one of the last, most offensive things that the Quraysh came up with. In the beginning, they called him a liar, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Then they called him crazy. They called him insane. They called him possessed by a jinn. They said that he's stealing from the Jews and the Christians. They came up with all kinds of allegations. But at the end of it all, you know what they said? They said, you keep talking about Yawmul Qiyamah. You keep talking about Jahannam. You keep talking about Jannah. You keep talking about angels. You keep talking about Allah. You keep talking about all this stuff that we can't see. Show me something. Bring the dead back to life. Turn this mountain into gold. Let's see the day of judgment. Let's see this punishment you keep talking about. إِنَّهُمْ يَرَوْنَهُ بَعِيدًا وَنَرَاهُ قَرِيبًا. Give me the they say, well, yasta'jilunaka bil'adhab, Quran tells us. They're telling you, hurry up and bring the punishment. Let's have it. I've been listening about it for 10 years now. I'm tired of it. You said it's near. I don't see it near. Let's see it. Let's see some action already. You know what that means? There's a saying we have in America. I'll tell you the saying. They say, I'll believe it when I see it. That's what they said. If you don't have something to show me, don't waste my time. I don't want to hear this Qur'an stuff. I'll believe it when I see it. I had a student like that in college. When I used to teach in college, I used to teach Arabic, and most of my students were non-Muslims. And a guy came up to me, and he is a student. He said, Professor, I like Islam. I like it. It's cool. But I just, you know, I haven't seen anything. Can you take me to like a jinn possession or something? If I could just see something, I'd be good. This surah, this beginning is the answer to that problem. Let me tell you, you guys have traffic problems in Malaysia, yes? Does the news, the radio tell you about traffic problems? Yeah? So you're driving on the highway, and it's no traffic, zero traffic. This is like amazing. And you're flooring the car, and you don't see any car in front of you. You turn the radio on, and it says 2 kilometers ahead of you. You see, I didn't say miles, I said kilometers. I'm proud of myself. 2 kilometers ahead of you. 2 kilometers ahead of you, there's an accident, there's really bad traffic. If you can take an exit, take the exit. That's what the radio tells you. Do you see the accident? No. You don't see the accident. But do you take the exit? If you listen to the radio and it says an accident, is a 5-hour delay. Will you take the exit or no? Yeah, you'll take the exit. I mean, maybe in America, you'll listen to the radio and say, I don't listen to the kuffar, I'm going to go into the traffic jam or something. But you'll take the exit. You know why? Because news came to you from a reliable source. The reporter sees something that you don't see, and you trust him. You don't say, these radio people, I will believe it when I see it. And you will go and get stuck in traffic. I believe now. There really is an accident. Like, what's the point now, buddy? Allah Azza wa Jal created human beings, right? And human beings are able to think and understand things even if they haven't seen them. Animals are not like that. If, for example, we made an announcement, brothers and sisters, please leave the building from this exit. If we made that announcement, we would start leaving from this exit. But if there was a cat in the building, if there was a fly in the building, if there was a dog, it won't be a dog, but whatever, it wouldn't leave. Why not? It doesn't have the ability to understand speech. But if an animal sees a fire, will it leave? When it sees a danger, will it leave? An animal will only behave when it sees. But a human being can behave when he understands, when she understands, right? Allah says that He taught the Qur'an, and He didn't give you anything else to believe. He gave you Qur'an's enough. Qur'an's enough for you. You know, there are other small miracles here and there, but the main message of Islam is the Qur'an itself. The miracle is Qur'an itself. Why? Because human beings are human beings. They're not animals. You don't have to see to believe. You can think about it and you can believe. That's why He says, عَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنَ and what? خَلَقَ الْإِنسَانِ He taught the Qur'an because He created the human being. You people aren't animals. If you say, I will only believe when I'll see, you're acting like a goat. You're acting like a cow. You're acting like a monkey, but you're not acting like a human. A human being can reason. The Qur'an is appealing to reason. Now, the final bit of this عَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنَ connection. I told you a teacher will get angry, right? A teacher will get angry. But this teacher, because he calls himself Allama al-Qur'an, he taught the Qur'an, so he's a teacher. Allah took the role of Mu'allim in this ayah. A teacher has a right to get angry, but he called himself Ar-Rahman first. He is a kind of teacher that has the kind of love and care and concern and mercy on top of all of that, even for the people who hate his messenger. Even for them. And he taught them the Qur'an, even when they insulted his messenger. He taught them the Qur'an, even when they tried to kill the messenger. He taught them the Qur'an when they killed innocent people in front of him. When they made fun of the ayat. When they rejected one surah, he revealed another, and another, and another, and another. And because he kept on revealing, that is proof that he is Ar-Rahman. Because if he was not Rahman, this would not have happened. You would have been killed a long time ago. You would have been dead. You would not have been around. What we are learning in this surah from the very beginning is the Qur'an came down as an act of Allah's love. There is so much propaganda against Islam today. When people think about the Qur'an, non-Muslims, unfortunately, when they think about the Qur'an, they think about violence, they think about hate, they think about hell, they think about a God that punishes. That's what they think about. And you know what's even more unfortunate? When Muslims today think about the Qur'an, they think about, oh, Qur'an just says everything's haram. Quran just says people will go to hellfire. Quran just says that we're not good enough, etc., etc. You have to understand something about Allah introducing the Quran. The Quran is an act of Allah's love. Is an act of Allah's care. You want to get to know Allah's love and care? Study the Quran. You want to know how He shows you love? Learn the Quran. And you will learn something about Allah you didn't know before. It'll move you to tears. It'll move you. Get to know Allah like you never did before.